In this video, I'm going to walk you through parallel execution in n8n. This feature allows you to run multiple tasks at the same time, making your workflows faster and more efficient. Mastering parallelization and sub-workflows can really take your automation skills to the next level. Let's dive in and see how it works. We're going to see some examples of how you can actually set that up. Parallelization is one of the many reasons why you may want to cut down a big workflow into some sub-workflows. So right now we're doing Google search with SERP API to get LinkedIn URL that are stored in a Google Sheet. Let's change the status to ready, and once we get LinkedIn URL, it will turn to processed. We have trigger, which will start the workflow. Then we have get tool to get the website from Google Sheet and AI agent. With the SERP API, it will Google and get LinkedIn URL. We have simple prompt to get LinkedIn URL using Google Search SERP API tool, and then it will update to Google Sheet. So we'll go ahead and execute the workflow. So right now it's working on the first website. As you can see, it just finished up the first one, and now it's going on to the second one, and so on. But if we would have had this agent running in parallel, this would have finished up much early. Let's see Google Sheet, and here it is updated. You may not see huge difference here, but in large workflow it does matter. I'm going to turn this into a parallel running workflow. But before we do that, what is parallelization? That is, you're running multiple tasks at the same time instead of one after another. I'm just going to show you guys how easy it is to get this set up. N8n has this cool feature where you can basically select nodes, click, and then say, I want to convert these selected nodes to a sub-workflow. And what happens is, when I click on this button, it's basically going mention name my workflow. When I hit confirm, it turns all of that into a sub-workflow. And it's already linked up right here and being called by this guy. And so if I click into this, you can see that it's passing in the name of the tool, which is pretty amazing. It's already configured. And I can click on this button right here, which will basically take us to that sub-execution. And we can see that everything is still set up and should run just fine for us. So what we did is we turned this into a sub-workflow, which is great, but we don't yet have parallelization because it would still run all through here. To make this actually run in parallel, we want all items to run as individual executions, and we want them all to run at the same time. So what I have to do is click into the node, and the first thing I'm going to do is, rather than run once with all items, I'm going to choose run once for each item, which means it's going to call the sub workflow individually for each item. And then once we've changed that, we have to do one tricky thing where we add an option and we want to turn off wait for sub workflow completion. If we left this checked on, it would basically send the first one and then wait for that one to finish, and then send the second one and wait for that one to finish. So that would be the same as basically looping through our list of items, and that would be even slower than the way we're currently doing it with sending all four items over there at once. So now that we have this configured properly, I'm going to go ahead and run this one once again. We're going to go into the sub workflow and click on executions, and you're going to see that all three items are running at the exact same time, and they're all finished up a lot quicker than the way we previously did it. So we'll go ahead and execute the workflow. And you can see right here, we now have all of them running completely in parallel. And they're all finished up a lot quicker. So you can see that all of these finished up parallelly. We can go into our Google Sheet and see. If you got any value out of this, I highly appreciate if you can like, and thank you so much for watching.